Is your PSU strong enough to power your PC? How efficient is it? And does that even matter? Well, we're gonna answer all of those questions and more as we look at NZXT's updated line of power supplies right here, right now on Robeytech. When it comes to choosing PC parts, power supplies, they don't get enough attention. Sure, we look at the amount of power it provides and efficiency ratings, but let's be honest, those things aren't as sexy as RGB lighting, overclocking potential, and all those rays yet to be traced. It's like the PSU has been designated the wingman for your components.
Good, not great.
It's always making sure that the other components have their time in the limelight. Well, it's about time that the PSU got its own wingman, and today that wingman is me. Well, me and NZXT, that is.
You can be my wingman anytime.
With the recent update to their C series of power supplies, NZXT asked if I, myself, Robeytech, would shine some light on what makes PSU so important, why efficiency matters, and how to choose the right PSU for you. With that in mind, we want to first thank NZXT for sponsoring this video, as well as tell you all about their humble PSUs, starting with NZXT's updated offerings. NZXT's C-Series Gold PSUs are available in 850-watt, 1,000-watt, and 1,200-watt versions, which are both available in either black or white. And this part right here is something new for NZXT. They've never offered white PSUs before, and the white versions even have all white sleeve cables as well. But that's not all. NZXT has also released the C1500 Platinum. This is a 1500 watt workhorse of a power supply with enough gas in the tank to power the most demanding components at a higher efficiency rating. This one is only available in black at the time of recording this video. Oh, and by the way, both the gold and platinum PSUs have 10-year warranties also. You've probably picked up on this by now, but in case you haven't, NZXT's naming convention for their PSUs follows an actual pattern. Its series, which in this case is the C series, followed by the PSU's wattage, and then ending with its efficiency rating. So, C850 Gold as their PSU. But before we can talk about how efficiency ratings work, we need to get a better picture of how a power supply works. This is going to be a gross oversimplification here, but this should demystify what your PSU is going to do and what you actually need it to do. Your power supply is like an ultimate StarCraft player. It takes resources and converts them into the right units for a victorious outcome. But instead of converting Vespian gas into void rays,
you require more Vespian gas.
A power supply takes AC power from your outlet, converts it to DC power, which is what your components need, and farms it out to the appropriate voltages for those components. Ultimately, this all leads to a smooth PC experience. This all happens as a combination of internal components transform, regulate, and filter the electrical signal to ensure that the DC power your components are getting is as clean and smooth as absolutely possible. One of the things NZXT has done to ensure stability specifically in the C1500 Platinum PSUs is that they've used high quality components like Japanese capacitors, which have an outstanding history for reliability and efficiency. Which brings us to efficiency. Now hang in there, we're about to get lost in some numbers.
I've got one. I'm thinking of a number between 1 and 100. What is it?
When we're talking about efficiency, there are a lot of factors involved. For several years, the biggest factor that people have looked at was the efficiency of power conversion from AC to DC power. Since there will always be some power lost through the conversion, PSUs targeted 80% efficiency. Now here's the math. PSU wattage divided by the efficiency of rating equals the actual power drawn from the wall. In other words, if you have a 500 watt power supply with an 80% efficiency, you would be drawing 625 watts from the wall to account for this loss. So the more efficient the PSU, the less you'll be drawing from the wall. You've probably heard of the Clear Result 80 Plus standard, which has been around for what seems like forever. Now to achieve 80 plus certification, PSUs are tested at 20%, 50%, and 100%. And their final rating depends on how efficient they are over that 80% efficiency threshold. Basically, the bigger the number, the more efficient the PSU. So when the new C850 Gold averaged 89.2% under 100% load, it went above and beyond that 80% efficiency, landing it within the 80 plus standard's gold rating range. Now this is only one standard of measuring efficiency. NZXT went a step further and had their new PSUs validated through cybernetics. This is a far more comprehensive series of PSU tests that looks at everything from average efficiency to power at standby, to the average noise level of the PSUs, and more. They even provide a full breakdown of their test results so you, the consumer, can check it out. When we look at the test results for NZXT's new C-Series PSUs, each of the C-Series Gold PSUs met cybernetic standards for gold level efficiency, but the C1500 Platinum didn't actually hit platinum. No, it actually exceeded it and hit titanium. Again, using our hypothetical PSU from before, a 500 watt power supply with Cybernetics titanium rating, which is between 91 and 93% efficiency, using the same math, which is wattage divided by efficiency, you would only need to draw 538 or 550 watts to convert to 500 watts, which is not bad at all. One final note on ratings here. Most of NZXT's new PSUs got an A- rating in Cybernetics noise rating tests. For context, that's a range of around 25 to 30 decibels. That's lower than whisper quiet. Now the only outlier was the C1000, which got an A with a noise level of 20 to 25 decibels, which is about as loud as the soft rustling of leaves. Now I'm sleeping. Okay, so we have a better understanding of what a PSU does and what efficiency is all about. But the big question remains, how do I choose the right PSU for my PC? Well, the first thing you need to know is what will actually fit inside your PC case. If you have a small form factor build, you may need an SFX or SFX-L power supply. However, most desktop PCs are going to use the ATX style PSU like the C-Series PSUs. Once you figure out physical size, the next step is to figure out how much power you need. This is where tools like PC Part Picker come in handy, or your local Robeytech video. Once you spec out your system, you'll be able to see an estimate of how much power those components will need, but this is where you need to do a little math. Calm down, it's not crazy math. Remember, your PSU needs to overshoot the amount of power your parts need to account for things like loss during power conversion, potential spikes, and performance decay over time. You also need to think about future upgrades, any overclocking you may want to do, and all the RGB you know you're going to put inside of your rig. We polled some friends in the tech space and did a little of our own research to find out if there was like a tried and true number, and it was all over the place. Anywhere from 20% to 50% overhead. So here is our recommendation. Plan for between 20 to 30% over what your PC part picker says your parts need. If you go beyond that, that's completely fine too. Your PSU is only gonna draw the power your parts actually need, nothing more. Since C-Series PSUs come in a few different levels of power, let's look at a few different types of builds and where the PSUs would fit. Let's say you're building a system with an Intel Core i7-14700K or either of the AMD Ryzen 7s, either that's a 7700X or a 7800X3D. Then you pair that CPU with either a RTX 4070 Super or an RX 7800XT from Radeon. For a system in that range, the C850 would be a great fit. The combination of 14700K and 4070 Super allows the C850 to have around 33% of overhead to work with. Fun discovery here. Intel CPUs tend to draw more power than AMD's, which most of us knew, but did you know AMD's GPUs actually draw more power than NVIDIA's counterparts? Something worth keeping in mind when you're planning out your builds. When we bump up a tier to the 14900K or the 7950X and an RX 7900 XTX or RTX 4080 Super, the C1000 Gold would comfortably power this rig with enough overhead to expand. Now, if you wanted to put in an RTX 4090 into an Intel configuration, the C1200 may be a better fit here. But if you want to go full ham, we're talking about a 14900KS or an overclocked 7950X and you're overclocking your 4090 and you've got RGB that you can see from the moon. You could do a C1200, but the C1500 Platinum may actually be a better fit for you. That's a lot of ground we covered in a short time, so let's recap. Your power supply needs to make sure your PC components have the right amount of power, that the power they're getting is clean and stable, and that it's converted efficiently. In each of those regards, NZXT's updated C-Series PSUs get the job done while reaching beyond gold to do it. But don't just take our word for it. Go check them out for yourselves and dig into the cybernetics research too, especially if you love numbers. I know like three people raised their hand right there. That was, thank you for the three of you, go do it. Now we hope that this has helped you see the PSU in a better light. They may not be the most handsome of components, but the right one sure is handy. And I'll tell you what, it's the one thing you do not want to skimp on. Now we want to give a huge shout out to NZXT for sponsoring this video and for giving us the opportunity to check out their new C-Series PSUs. But we want to know what you think. Did we help you get a bit more invested in your next PSU purchase? Then boom, we did our job. Let us know down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here on Robeytech. Also, if you want to continue the conversation or have additional questions about these PSUs, head over to our Discord server, discord.gg/Robeytech. Amazing place to go and talk to other tech and PC enthusiasts that love to answer these questions. And you know what? You might just make a friend. Also, make sure you follow us on all the socials at Robeytech, absolutely everywhere. Thank you so much for watching this video, and we will see you on the next one.